18 years ago, Mr. Martin Keown, do you remember the day? Old Trafford, do you remember the match?
Oh, yes.
Manchester United against Arsenal, and it all kicked off. The infamous Battle of Old Trafford. And on that occasion, of course, the same Mr. Martin Keown got up close and personal with one Ruud van Nistelrooy. It all kicked off, didn't it? And so many Arsenal fans talk about it today, so many Manchester United fans still talk about it today. This was Martin's then-teammate, Ray Parler's, view of this. Ray was talking on Drive this week, and this is how he recollected the moment and Mr. Keown's involvement.
Well, I think Martin was more relieved than anything because he gave away the penalty. And I would have had my house on Van Nistelrooy scoring. Jens Lehmann was a great goalkeeper. Tried to put him off, but it's Ruud van Nistelrooy, end of the day. And you're probably... I was on the edge of the area. I'm going to follow him because you have to. But you think he's going to be in the back of the net here. And the game's over. 1-0 to Manchester United, which is a big blow for our season. So I think it was a lot of relief. And, you know, we was a little bit out of order at the end, I must admit. But that was the game. That was a tension game.
How much did you get fined for
that? I got fined £10,000. Martin got fined 20 grand, I think. He was the man. But he started it, that's why.
20 grand.
He got 20. And Ashley got 5,000.
Yeah.
And Lauren, £5,000. Now, Lauren... The funny thing about Lauren, he was all sitting in the dressing room because the fines come through 2 weeks later from the FA. So we was all sitting in there and I said, Martin, you open your letter up first because you started it and whatever you get fined, we'd be less than you. So he opened his letter up and it was 20,000. I thought, oh no, I've got to be 15. I've thought about 10, 15. So 10 grand and then obviously it goes down, Ashley 5,000 and Lauren 5,000. But funny thing about Lauren, he looked at it and went, my wife will kill me. And I was trying to explain to Lauren, saying, Lauren, this is what it... Oh, I can't believe it. Can I appeal? I said, Lauren, you know, we was out of order what we did. But it was the heat of the moment and we probably regret it, what we did. But I'm sure Manchester United players would have probably done exactly the same as us in the heat of the moment.
Yeah, yeah.
And the other way, with Roy Keane and all them sort of guys as well.
So, Martin, now we know you started it. Now we know the size of the fines. Did Parler go into just a little too much detail there for you?
No. No, not at all.
Is it accurate about what you said?
It's not accurate in terms of who started it. Who started it? You have to go all the way back to Patrick Vieira being sent off.
Yeah.
Ruud van Nistelrooy feigns injury. You could say it's cheating. He goes down and Patrick Vieira is sent off. And then after that, it was like the Alamo because they saw they had a chance to win the game.
Yeah.
There's a penalty, which you could argue wasn't a penalty, which I'm involved in. A few finger pointing from some of my teammates, and then he misses. And of course, then he's the figure of hate, really, because we're only in that position, we feel, because he's got one of our colleagues sent off, Ruud van Nistelrooy. That's when...
So he got Patrick sent off, and then he misses the penalty, and then, as far as you're concerned, the red mist descended.
Well, just gave it in rear. So, I mean, people say, do you regret? I don't really regret anything in my life, you know? You look back, if it was right then, it's right now. When I make my decisions, that's how I am. I don't really enjoy what it might represent and then what it meant to the football club in terms of fines, in terms of suspensions. Lauren got 4 games, I got 3 games, Vieira 1 game, Parler 1 game. It's unbelievable when you look back at it. £275,000 worth of fines.
Oof.
But something that little do people know, that actually I was only earning 25% of my wages was like a flat fee. The rest, 85%, so the rest of it, 75% came in appearance money. So it was actually costing me far more than the figures that have ever been revealed.
So it cost you, you paid a heavy price for it.
I did, and let's say the FA changed the roof down at the FA headquarters based on the money they got from that one. The Manchester United players, I think they got £7,000 and £4,000 a piece, no suspensions. But look,
you're saying if it happened again this Saturday, you'd behave in exactly the same way?
I don't try to preempt anything like that. It was an emotion, raw emotion. There was a massive rivalry between these two football clubs. And it was a game within a game. Every time the referee made a decision, we had to be there with them because we didn't want the referee to influence it.
Yeah.
Now you get told off for that. Oh, you can't condone that. You can't have young players doing it. But I'm telling you, you can influence. And Manchester United felt like they were influencing.
Have you patched up with Van Nistelrooy?
I've immediately afterwards, I think the FA Cup game, I went to shake his hands. He cowered a little bit, but I said, I was apologising. I did say...
What do you mean? What did he do?
He just sort of tried to back away, but I shook his hand and said, don't take it personal. Do you know? Yeah. So, and I don't think any of those guys really did.
So you walked up, you shook him warmly by the throat, and he was all right then.
So they put us out of the FA Cup, by the way, that week. And yeah, that's another story. I think they went to work on Reyes. God rest his soul. Mm. A beautiful player. Mm.
So what are we going to see then this weekend? So it's, I mean, Arsenal, where do you start? From your point of view, from an Arsenal point of view, what do you want to see?
I want to see Arsenal starting back to getting back to where they were before. I want a team of fighters. I can see a little bit at Burnley. I saw some of the ingredients there, characters emerging. You know, okay, it wasn't brilliant. At one end, looked to Aubameyang, didn't look like he was really at the races. Pepe making mistakes, but the positives were the back of the team, Partey coming in, really galvanised the team. And that's what you're going to need against Tottenham. And Nuno is tough for Nuno, by the way, coming in. So this is a difficult one to call, but I'm certainly hoping Arsenal can do something big now.
Yeah. Okay, okay.
We keep dreaming, Jim.
Yeah. Listen, Martin, brilliant. Brilliant having you on board. I love the fact he doesn't regret a thing
that's
about
great
that day.
Quite,
I
mean,
I saw you nodding. That is absolutely your outlook, isn't
it? Yeah, absolutely.
It? Absolutely.
Regret.
Absolutely.
But great to hear it from Martin, because you get that insight that you don't get just by watching things.
Yeah. Martin, great to have you on board today. Birthday boy, what's happening?
Enjoy the day, Simon.
You're off to a posh restaurant this afternoon.
I might go to the Ivy, I think.
Oh, really? Right, okay. Are you going to elaborate on that? Or is it a table for one?
Yes, I can elaborate on the fact that you're not invited.
Get your coat, Jim.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
From all of
Thank
us you. Here
Thank
at TalkSport.
Thank you.
Paul and Andy are on the way.